If you're listening to this, you are the resistance.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis uccelli et terra, gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini.
In my holy mountain, the foregoing verse, to make the sense complete, must be understood so as to condemn and reject that mixture of worship which the Jews then followed. In this verse, God promises to the true Israelites, especially to those of the Christian Church, that they shall serve Him in another manner, in His holy mountain, the spiritual Sion, and shall be accepted of by Him. I will accept of you for an odor of sweetness, when I shall have brought you out from the people, and shall have gathered you out of the lands into which you are scattered, and I will be sanctified anew in the sight of the nations. And you shall know that I am the Lord, when I shall have brought you into the land of Israel, into the land for which I lifted up my hands to give it to your fathers. And there you shall remember your ways, and all your wicked doings with which you have been defiled, and you shall be displeased with yourselves in your own sight, for all your wicked deeds which you committed. And you shall know that I am the Lord, when I shall have done well by you for my own name's sake, and not according to your evil ways, nor according to your wicked deeds, O house of Israel, saith the Lord God. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, set thy face against the way of the south, and drop towards the south, and prophesy against the forest of the south field. And say to the south forest, Hear the word of the Lord, thus saith the Lord God, Behold, I will kindle a fire in thee, and will burn in thee every green tree, and every dry tree, the flame of the fire shall not be quenched, and every face shall be burned in it, from the south even to the north. And all flesh shall see, that I the Lord have kindled it, and it shall not be quenched. And I said, Ah, 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 O Lord God, they say of me, Doth not this man speak by parables? Of the south, Jerusalem lay towards the south of Babylon, where the prophet then was, and is here called the forest of the south field, and is threatened with utter desolation. The destruction of Jerusalem by the sword is further described, the ruin also of the Ammonites is foreshewn. And finally Babylon, the destroyer of others, shall be destroyed. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, set thy face toward Jerusalem, and let thy speech flow towards the holy places, and prophesy against the land of Israel, and say to the land of Israel, Thus saith the Lord God, Behold, I come against thee, and I will draw forth my sword out of its sheath, and will cut off in thee the just, and the wicked. And forasmuch as I have cut off in thee the just, and the wicked, therefore shall my sword go forth out of its sheath against all flesh, from the south even to the north. That all flesh may know that I the Lord have drawn my sword out of its sheath not to be turned back. And thou, son of man, mourn with the breaking of thy loins, and with bitterness sigh before them. And when they shall say to thee, Why mournest thou? Thou shalt say, For that which I hear, because it cometh, and every heart shall melt, and all hands shall be made feeble, and every spirit shall faint, and water shall run down every knee, behold it cometh, and it shall be done, saith the Lord God. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, prophesy, and say, Thus saith the Lord God, say, the sword is sharpened, and furbished. It is sharpened to kill victims, it is furbished that it may glitter, thou removest the scepter of my son, thou hast cut down every tree. Thou removest the scepter of my son, he speaks, according to Saint Jerome, to the sword of Nebuchadnezzar, which was about to remove the scepter of Israel, whom God here calls his son. And I have given it to be furbished, that it may be handled, this sword is sharpened, and it is furbished, that it may be in the hand of the slayer. Cry, and howl, O son of man, for this sword is upon my people, it is upon all the princes of Israel, that are fled, they are delivered up to the sword with my people, strike therefore upon thy thigh, because it is tried, and that when it shall overthrow the scepter, and it shall not be, saith the Lord God. Thou therefore, O son of man, prophesy, and strike thy hands together, and let the sword be doubled, and let the sword of the slain be tripled, this is the sword of a great slaughter, that maketh them stand amazed, and languish in heart, and that multiplieth ruins. In all their gates I have set the dread of the sharp sword, the sword that is furbished to glitter, that is made ready for slaughter. Be thou sharpened, go to the right hand, or to the left, which way soever thou hast a mind to set thy face. And I will clap my hands together, and will satisfy my indignation, I the Lord have spoken. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, And thou son of man, set thee two ways, for the sword of the king of Babylon to come, both shall come forth out of one land, and with his hand he shall draw lots, he shall consult at the head of the way of the city. Thou shalt make a way that the sword may come to Rabbath of the children of Ammon, and to Judah unto Jerusalem the strong city. For the king of Babylon stood in the highway, at the head of two ways, seeking divination, shuffling arrows, he inquired of the idols, and consulted entrails. On his right hand was the divination for Jerusalem, to set battering rams, to open the mouth in slaughter, to lift up the voice in howling, to set engines against the gates, to cast up a mount, to build forts. And he shall be in their eyes as one consulting the oracle in vain, and imitating the leisure of Sabbaths, but he will call to remembrance the iniquity that they may be taken. Therefore thus saith the Lord God, because you have remembered your iniquity, and have discovered your prevarications, and your sins have appeared in all your devices, because, I say, you have remembered, you shall be taken with the hand. But thou profane wicked prince of Israel, whose day is come that hath been appointed in the time of iniquity. Thou profane, he speaks to King Sedecius, who had broken his oath, and was otherwise a wicked prince. Thus saith the Lord God, remove the diadem, take off the crown, is it not this that hath exalted the low one, and brought down him that was high? I will show it to be iniquity, 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 but this was not done till he came to whom judgment belongeth, and I will give it him. And thou son of man, prophesy, and say, thus saith the Lord God concerning the children of Ammon, and concerning their reproach, and thou shalt say, O sword, come out of the scabbard to kill, be furbished to destroy, and to glitter, whilst they see vain things in thy regard, and they divine lies, to bring thee upon the necks of the wicked that are wounded, whose appointed day is come in the time of iniquity. Return into thy sheath. I will judge thee in the place wherein thou wast created, in the land of thy nativity. Is it not this that hath exalted the low one? The royal crown of Judah had exalted Sedecius from a private state and condition to the sovereign power, as the loss of it had brought down Jeconias, etc. I will show it to be iniquity, or, I will overturn it, viz., the crown of Judah for the manifold iniquities of the kings, but it shall not be utterly removed, till Christ come whose right it is, and who shall reign in the spiritual house of Jacob, that is, in his church, forevermore. Concerning their reproach, by which they had reproached and insulted over the Jews, at the time of the destruction of Jerusalem. Return into thy sheath, the sword of Babylon, after raging against many nations, was shortly to be judged and destroyed at home by the Medes and Persians. And I will pour out upon thee my indignation, in the fire of my rage will I blow upon thee, and will give thee into the hands of men that are brutish and contrive thy destruction. Thou shalt be fuel for the fire, thy blood shall be in the midst of the land, thou shalt be forgotten, for I the Lord have spoken it. The general corruption of the inhabitants of Jerusalem, for which God will consume them as dross in his furnace. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, And thou son of man, dost thou not judge the city of blood? And thou shalt show her all her abominations, and shalt say, Thus saith the Lord God, This is the city that sheddeth blood in the midst of her, that her time may come, and that hath made idols against herself, to defile herself. Thou art become guilty in thy blood which thou hast shed, and thou art defiled in thy idols which thou hast made, and thou hast made thy days to draw near, and hast brought on the time of thy years, therefore have I made thee a reproach to the Gentiles, and a mockery to all countries. Those that are near, and those that are far from thee, shall triumph over thee, thou filthy one, infamous, great in destruction. Behold the princes of Israel. Every one hath employed his arm in thee to shed blood. They have abused father and mother in thee, they have oppressed the stranger in the midst of thee, they have grieved the fatherless and widow in thee. Thou hast despised my sanctuaries, and profaned my Sabbaths. Slanderers have been in thee to shed blood, and they have eaten upon the mountains in thee, they have committed wickedness in the midst of thee. They have discovered the nakedness of their father in thee. They have humbled the uncleanness of the menstruous woman in thee. And every one hath committed abomination with his neighbor's wife, and the father-in-law hath wickedly defiled his daughter-in-law, the brother hath oppressed his sister the daughter of his father in thee. They have taken gifts and each shed blood. Thou hast taken usury and increase, and hast covetously oppressed thy neighbors, and thou hast forgotten me, saith the Lord God. Behold, I have clapped my hands at thy covetousness, which thou hast exercised, and at the blood that hath been shed in the midst of thee. Shall thy heart endure, or shall thy hands prevail ill the days which I will bring upon thee? I the Lord have spoken, and will do it. And I will disperse thee in the nations, and will scatter thee among the countries, and I will put an end to thy uncleanness in thee. And I will possess thee in the sight of the Gentiles, and thou shalt know that I am the Lord. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, the house of Israel is become dross to me, all these are brass, and tin, and iron, and lead, in the midst of the furnace, they are become the dross of silver. Therefore thus saith the Lord God, because you are all turned into dross, therefore behold I will gather you together in the midst of Jerusalem. As they gather silver, and brass, and tin, and iron, and lead in the midst of the furnace, that I may kindle a fire in it to melt it, so will I gather you together in my fury and in my wrath, and will take my rest, and I will melt you down. And I will gather you together, and will burn you in the fire of my wrath, and you shall be melted in the midst thereof. As silver is melted in the midst of the furnace, so shall you be in the midst thereof, and you shall know that I am the Lord, when I have poured out my indignation upon you. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, say to her, Thou art a land that is unclean, and not rained upon in the day of wrath. There is a conspiracy of prophets in the midst thereof, like a lion that roareth and catcheth the prey. They have devoured souls, they have taken riches in hire, they have made many widows in the midst thereof. Her priests have despised my law, and have defiled my sanctuaries. They have put no difference between holy and profane, nor have distinguished between the polluted and the clean, and they have turned away their eyes from my Sabbaths, and I was profaned in the midst of them. Her princes in the midst of her are like wolves ravening the prey to shed blood, and to destroy souls, and to run after gains through covetousness. And her prophets have dogged them without tempering the mortar, seeing vain things, and divining lies unto them, saying, Thus saith the Lord God, when the Lord hath not spoken. The people of the land have used oppression, and committed robbery, they afflicted the needy and poor, and they oppressed the stranger by calumny without judgment. And I sought among them for a man that might set up a hedge, and stand in the gap before me in favor of the land, that I might not destroy it, and I found none. And I poured out my indignation upon them, in the fire of my wrath I consumed them, I have rendered their way upon their own head, saith the Lord God. Under the names of the two harlots, Ohola and Oholibah, are described the manifold disloyalties of Samaria and Jerusalem, with the punishment of them both. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, there were two women, daughters of one mother. And they committed fornication in Egypt, in their youth they committed fornication, there were their breasts pressed down, and the teats of their virginity were bruised. And their names were Ohola the elder, and Oholibah her younger sister, and I took them, and they bore sons and daughters. Now for their names, Samaria is Ohola, and Jerusalem is Oholibah. And Ohola committed fornication against me, and doted on her lovers, on the Assyrians that came to her. Committed fornication, that is, idolatry. Ohola the elder, and Oholibah her younger, God calls the kingdom of Israel Ohola, which signifies their own habitation, because they separated themselves from his temple, and the kingdom of Judah, Oholibah, which signifies his habitation in her, because of his temple among them in Jerusalem. On the Assyrians, that is, the idols of the Assyrians, for all that is said in this chapter of the fornications of Israel and Judah, is to be understood in a spiritual sense, of their disloyalty to the Lord, by worshipping strange gods, who were clothed with blue, princes, and rulers, beautiful youths, all horsemen, mounted upon horses. And she committed her fornications with those chosen men, all sons of the Assyrians, and she defiled herself with the uncleanness of all them on whom she doted. Moreover also she did not forsake her fornications which she had committed in Egypt, for they also lay with her in her youth, and they bruised the breasts of her virginity, and poured out their fornication upon her. Therefore have I delivered her into the hands of her lovers, into the hands of the sons of the Assyrians, upon whose lust she doted. They discovered her disgrace, took away her sons and daughters, and slew her with the sword, and they became infamous women, and they executed judgments in her. And when her sister Oholibah saw this, she was mad with lust more than she, and she carried her fornication beyond the fornication of her sister, impudently prostituting herself to the children of the Assyrians, the princes, and rulers that came to her, clothed with divers colors, to the horsemen that rode upon horses, and to young men all of great beauty. And I saw that she was defiled, and that they both took one way. And she increased her fornications, and when she had seen men painted on the wall, the images of the Chaldeans set forth in colors, and girded with girdles about their reins, and with dyed turbans on their heads, the resemblance of all the captains, the likeness of the sons of Babylon, and of the land of the Chaldeans wherein they were born. She doted upon them with the lust of her eyes, and she sent messengers to them into Chaldea. And when the sons of Babylon were come to her to the bed of love, they defiled her with their fornications, and she was polluted by them, and her soul was glutted with them. And she discovered her fornications, and discovered her disgrace, and my soul was alienated from her, as my soul was alienated from her sister. For she multiplied her fornications, remembering the days of her youth, in which she played the harlot in the land of Egypt. And she was mad with lust after lying with them whose flesh is as the flesh of asses, and whose issue as the issue of horses. And thou hast renewed the wickedness of thy youth, when thy breasts were pressed in Egypt, and the paps of thy virginity broken. Therefore, Oholibah, thus saith the Lord God, behold, I will raise up against thee all thy lovers with whom thy soul hath been glutted, and I will gather them together against thee round about. The children of Babylon, and all the Chaldeans, the nobles, and the kings, and princes, all the sons of the Assyrians, beautiful young men, all the captains, and rulers, the princes of princes, and the renowned horsemen. And they shall come upon thee well appointed with chariot and wheel, a multitude of people, they shall be armed against thee on every side with breastplate, and buckler, and helmet, and I will set judgment before them, and they shall judge thee by their judgments. And I will set my jealousy against thee, which they shall execute upon thee with fury, they shall cut off thy nose and thy ears, and what remains shall fall by the sword, they shall take thy sons, and thy daughters, and thy residue shall be devoured by fire. And they shall strip thee of thy garments, and take away the instruments of thy glory. And I will put an end to thy wickedness in thee, and thy fornication brought out of the land of Egypt. Neither shalt thou lift up thy eyes to them, nor remember Egypt any more. For thus saith the Lord God, behold, I will deliver thee into the hands of them whom thou hatest, into their hands with whom thy soul hath been glutted. And they shall deal with thee in hatred, and they shall take away all thy labors, and shall let thee go naked, and full of disgrace, and the disgrace of thy fornication shall be discovered, thy wickedness, and thy fornications. They have done these things to thee, because thou hast played the harlot with the nations among which thou wast defiled with their idols. Thou hast walked in the way of thy sister, and I will give her cup into thy hand. Thus saith the Lord God, thou shalt drink thy sister's cup, deep and wide, thou shalt be head in derision and scorn, which containeth very much. Thou shalt be filled with drunkenness, and sorrow, with the cup of grief, and sadness, with the cup of thy sister Samaria. And thou shalt drink it, and shalt drink it up even to the dregs, and thou shalt devour the fragments thereof, thou shalt rend thy breasts, because I have spoken it, saith the Lord God. Therefore thus saith the Lord God, because thou hast forgotten me, and hast cast me off behind thy back, bear thou also thy wickedness, and thy fornications. And the Lord spoke to me, saying, Son of man, dost thou judge Oholibah, and Oholibah, and dost thou declare to them their wicked deeds? Because they have committed adultery, and blood is in their hands, and they have committed fornication with their idols, moreover also their children, whom they bore to me, they have offered to them to be devoured. Yea, and they have done this to me. They polluted my sanctuary on the same day, and profaned my Sabbaths. And when they sacrificed their children to their idols, and went into my sanctuary the same day to profane it, they did these things even in the midst of my house. They sent for men coming from afar, to whom they had sent a messenger, and behold they came, for whom thou didst wash thyself, and didst paint thy eyes, and wast adorned with womenish ornaments. Thou sattest on a very fine bed, and a table was decked before thee, whereupon thou didst set my incense, and my ointment. And there was in her the voice of a multitude rejoicing, and to some that were brought of the multitude of men, and that came from the desert, they put bracelets on their hands, and beautiful crowns on their heads. And I said to her that was worn out in her adulteries, Now will this woman still continue in her fornication? And they went into her, as to a harlot, so went they in unto Oholah, and Oholibah, wicked women. They therefore are just men, these shall judge them as adulteresses are judged, and as shedders of blood are judged, because they are adulteresses, and blood is in their hands. For thus saith the Lord God, Bring a multitude upon them, and deliver them over to tumult and rapine, and let the people stone them with stones, and let them be stabbed with their swords, they shall kill their sons and daughters, and their houses they shall burn with fire. And I will take away wickedness out of the land, and all women shall learn, not to do according to the wickedness of them. And they shall render your wickedness upon you, and you shall bear the sins of your idols, and you shall know that I am the Lord God. Under the parable of a boiling pot is shown the utter destruction of Jerusalem, for which the Jews at Babylon shall not dare to mourn. And the word of the Lord came to me in the ninth year, in the tenth month, the tenth day of the month, saying, Son of man, write thee the name of this day, on which the king of Babylon hath set himself against Jerusalem today. And thou shalt speak by a figure a parable to the provoking house, and say to them, Thus saith the Lord God, Set on a pot, set it on, I say, and put water into it. Heap together into it the pieces thereof, every good piece, the thigh and the shoulder, choice pieces and full of bones. Take the fattest of the flock, and lay together piles of bones under it, the seething thereof is boiling hot, and the bones thereof are thoroughly sodden in the midst of it. Therefore thus saith the Lord God, Woe to the bloody city, to the pot whose rust is in it, and its rust is not gone out of it, cast it out piece by piece, there hath no lot fallen upon it. For her blood is in the midst of her, she hath shed it upon the smooth rock, she hath not shed it upon the ground, that it might be covered with dust. And that I might bring my indignation upon her, and take my vengeance, I have shed her blood upon the smooth rock, that it should not be covered. Therefore thus saith the Lord God, Woe to the bloody city, of which I will make a great bonfire. Heap together the bones, which I will burn with fire, the flesh shall be consumed, and the whole composition shall be sodden, and the bones shall be consumed. Then set it empty upon burning coals, that it may be hot, and the brass thereof may be melted, and let the filth of it be melted in the midst thereof, and let the rust of it be consumed. Great pains have been taken, and the great rust thereof is not gone out, not even by fire. Thy uncleanness is execrable, because I desired to cleanse thee, and thou art not cleansed from thy filthiness, neither shalt thou be cleansed, before I cause my indignation to rest in thee. I the Lord have spoken, it shall come to pass, and I will do it, I will not pass by, nor spare, nor be pacified, I will judge thee according to thy ways, and according to thy doings, saith the Lord. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, behold I take from thee the desire of thy eyes with a stroke, and thou shalt not lament, nor weep, neither shall thy tears run down. Sigh in silence, make no mourning for the dead, let the tire of thy head be upon thee, and thy shoes on thy feet, and cover not thy face, nor eat the meat of mourners. So I spoke to the people in the morning, and my wife died in the evening, and I did in the morning as he had commanded me. And the people said to me, Why dost thou not tell us what these things mean that thou doest? And I said to them, The word of the Lord came to me, saying, Speak to the house of Israel, Thus saith the Lord God, Behold I will profane my sanctuary, the glory of your realm, and the thing that your eyes desire, and for which your soul feareth, your sons, and your daughters, whom you have left, shall fall by the sword. And you shall do as I have done, you shall not cover your faces, nor shall you eat the meat of mourners. You shall have crowns on your heads, and shoes on your feet. You shall not lament nor weep, but you shall pine away for your iniquities, and every one shall sigh with his brother. And Ezekiel shall be unto you for a sign of things to come, according to all that he hath done. So shall you do, when this shall come to pass, and you shall know that I am the Lord God. And thou, O son of man, behold in the day wherein I will take away from them their strength, and the joy of their glory, and the desire of their eyes, upon which their souls rest, their sons and their daughters. In that day when he that escapeth shall come to thee, to tell thee, in that day, I say, shall thy mouth be open to him that hath escaped, and thou shalt speak, and shalt be silent no more, and thou shalt be unto them for a sign of things to come, and you shall know that I am the Lord. A prophecy against the Ammonites, Moabites, Edomites, and Philistines, for their malice against the Israelites. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, set thy face against the children of Ammon, and thou shalt prophesy of them. And thou shalt say to the children of Ammon, Hear ye the word of the Lord God, thus saith the Lord God, because thou hast said, Ha, ha, upon my sanctuary, because it was profaned, and upon the land of Israel, because it was laid waste, and upon the house of Judah, because they are led into captivity, therefore will I deliver thee to the men of the east for an inheritance, and they shall place their sheepgates in thee, and shall set up their tents in thee, they shall eat thy fruits, and they shall drink thy milk. And I will make Rabbath a stable for camels, and the children of Ammon a couching place for flocks, and you shall know that I am the Lord. Rabbath, the capital city of the Ammonites, it was afterwards called Philadelphia. For thus saith the Lord God, because thou hast clapped thy hands and stamped with thy foot, and hast rejoiced with all thy heart against the land of Israel, therefore behold I will stretch forth my hand upon thee, and will deliver thee to be the spoil of nations, and will cut thee off from among the people, and destroy thee out of the lands, and break thee in pieces, and thou shalt know that I am the Lord. Thus saith the Lord God, because Moab and Seir have said, Behold the house of Judah is like all other nations, therefore behold I will open the shoulder of Moab from the cities, I say, and his borders, the noble cities of the land of Beth-Yesimoth, and Beel-Meon, and Kiriath-Haim, to the people of the east with the children of Ammon, and I will give it them for an inheritance, that there may be no more any remembrance of the children of Ammon among the nations. And I will execute judgments in Moab, and they shall know that I am the Lord. Thus saith the Lord God, because Edom hath taken vengeance to revenge herself of the children of Judah, and hath greatly offended, and hath sought revenge of them, therefore thus saith the Lord God, I will stretch forth my hand upon Edom, and will take away out of it man and beast, and will make it desolate from the south, and they that are in Dedan shall fall by the sword. And I will lay my vengeance upon Edom by the hand of my people Israel, and they shall do in Edom according to my wrath, and my fury, and they shall know my vengeance, saith the Lord God. Thus saith the Lord God, because the Philistines have taken vengeance, and have revenged themselves with all their mind, destroying and satisfying old enmities. Therefore thus saith the Lord God, Behold I will stretch forth my hand upon the Philistines, and will kill the killers, and will destroy the remnant of the sea coast. And I will execute great vengeance upon them, rebuking them in fury, and they shall know that I am the Lord, when I shall lay my vengeance upon them. A prophecy of the destruction of the famous city of Tyre by Nebuchadnezzar. And it came to pass in the 11th year, the first day of the month, that the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, because Tyre hath said of Jerusalem, Aha, the gates of the people are broken, she is turned to me, I shall be filled, now she is laid waste. Therefore thus saith the Lord God, Behold I come against thee, O Tyre, and I will cause many nations to come up to thee, as the waves of the sea rise up. And they shall break down the walls of Tyre, and destroy the towers thereof, and I will scrape her dust from her, and make her like a smooth rock. She shall be a drying place for nets in the midst of the sea, because I have spoken it, saith the Lord God, and she shall be a spoil to the nations. Her daughters also that are in the field, shall be slain by the sword, and they shall know that I am the Lord. For thus saith the Lord God, Behold, I will bring against Tyre Nebuchadnezzar king of Babylon, the king of kings, from the north, with horses, and chariots, and horsemen, and companies, and much people. Thy daughters that are in the field, he shall kill with the sword, and he shall compass thee with forts, and shall cast up a mount round about, and he shall lift up the buckler against thee. And he shall set engines of war and battering rams against thy walls, and shall destroy thy towers with his arms. By reason of the multitude of his horses, their dust shall cover thee, thy walls shall shake at the noise of the horsemen, and wheels, and chariots, when they shall go in at thy gates, as by the entrance of a city that is destroyed. With the hoofs of his horses he shall tread down all thy streets, thy people he shall kill with the sword, and thy famous statues shall fall to the ground. They shall waste thy riches, they shall make a spoil of thy merchandise, and they shall destroy thy walls, and pull down thy fine houses, and they shall lay thy stones and thy timber, and thy dust in the midst of the waters. And I will make the multitude of thy songs to cease, and the sound of thy harps shall be heard no more. And I will make thee like a naked rock, thou shalt be a drying place for nets, neither shalt thou be built any more, for I have spoken it, saith the Lord God. Thus saith the Lord God to Tyre, shall not the island shake at the sound of thy fall, and the groans of thy slain when they shall be killed in the midst of thee? Then all the princes of the sea shall come down from their thrones, and take off their robes, and cast away their broidered garments, and be clothed with astonishment, they shall sit on the ground, and with amazement shall wonder at thy sudden fall. And taking up a lamentation over thee, they shall say to thee, how art thou fallen, that dwellest in the sea, renowned city that wast strong in the sea, with thy inhabitants whom all did dread. Now shall the ships be astonished in the day of thy terror, and the islands in the sea shall be troubled because no one cometh out of thee. For thus saith the Lord God, when I shall make thee a desolate city like the cities that are not inhabited, and shall bring the deep upon thee, and many waters shall cover thee, and when I shall bring thee down with those that descend into the pit to the everlasting people, and shall set thee in the lowest parts of the earth, as places desolate of old, with them that are brought down into the pit, that thou be not inhabited, and when I shall give glory in the land of the living, I will bring thee to nothing, and thou shalt not be, and if thou be sought for, thou shalt not be found any more forever, saith the Lord God. A description of the glory and riches of Tyre, and of her irrecoverable fall. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, thou therefore, O son of man, take up a lamentation for Tyre, and say to Tyre that dwelleth at the entry of the sea, being the mart of the people for many islands, thus saith the Lord God, O Tyre, thou hast said, I am of perfect beauty, and situate in the heart of the sea. Thy neighbors, that built thee, have perfected thy beauty, with fir trees of Sanir they have built thee with all sea planks, they have taken cedars from Libanus to make thee masts. Sea planks, that is, timber brought by sea to build the city. They have cut thy oars out of the oaks of Basan, and they have made thee benches of Indian ivory and cabins with things brought from the islands of Italy. Fine broidered linen from Egypt was woven for thy sail, to be spread on thy mast, blue and purple from the islands of Elisa, were made thy covering. The inhabitants of Sidon, and the Arabians were thy rowers, thy wise men, O Tyre, were thy pilots. The ancients of Jebel, and the wise men thereof furnished mariners for the service of thy various furniture, all the ships of the sea, and their mariners were thy factors. The Persians, and Lydians, and the Libyans were thy soldiers in thy army, they hung up the buckler and the helmet in thee for thy ornament. The men of Arad were with thy army upon thy walls round about, the Pygmies also that were in thy towers, hung up their quivers on thy walls round about, they perfected thy beauty. The Carthaginians thy merchants supplied thy fares with a multitude of all kinds of riches, with silver, iron, tin, and lead. Greece, Thubal, and Mozok, they were thy merchants, they brought to thy people slaves and vessels of brass. From the house of Thagarma they brought horses, and horsemen, and mules to thy market. The men of Dedan were thy merchants, many islands were the traffic of thy hand, they exchanged for thy prize teeth of ivory and ebony. Pygmies, that is, strong and valiant men. In Hebrew, Gamadim. The Syrian was thy merchant, by reason of the multitude of thy works. They set forth precious stones, and purple, and broidered works, and fine linen, and silk, and chatrot in thy market. Judah and the land of Israel, they were thy merchants with the best corn. They set forth balm, and honey, and oil, and rosin in thy fairs. The men of Damascus were thy merchants in the multitude of thy works, in the multitude of divers riches, in rich wine, in wool of the best color. Dan, and Greece, and Mosul have set forth in thy marts wrought iron, Stacte, and Calamus were in thy market. The men of Dedan were thy merchants in tapestry for seats. Chatrot, it is the Hebrew name for some precious stone, but of what kind in particular interpreters are not agreed. Arabia, and all the princes of Cedar, they were the merchants of thy hand. Thy merchants came to thee with lambs, and rams, and kids. The sellers of Sawa, and Rima, they were thy merchants, with all the best spices, and precious stones, and gold, which they set forth in thy market. Haran, and Chin, and Eden were thy merchants. Sawa, Asur, and Chelmad sold to thee. They were thy merchants in divers manners, with bales of blue cloth, and of embroidered work, and of precious riches, which were wrapped up and bound with cords. They had cedars also in thy merchandise. The ships of the sea were thy chief in thy merchandise, and thou wast replenished, and glorified exceedingly in the heart of the sea. Thy rowers have brought thee into great waters, the south wind hath broken thee in the heart of the sea. Thy riches, and thy treasures, and thy manifold furniture, thy mariners, and thy pilots, who kept thy goods, and were chief over thy people, thy men of war also, that were in thee, with all thy multitude that is in the midst of thee, shall fall in the heart of the sea in the day of thy ruin. Thy fleets shall be troubled at the sound of the cry of thy pilots. And all that handled the oar shall come down from their ships, the mariners, and all the pilots of the sea shall stand upon the land, and they shall mourn over thee with a loud voice, and shall cry bitterly, and they shall cast up dust upon their heads, and shall be sprinkled with ashes. And they shall shave themselves bald for thee, and shall be girded with hair cloth, and they shall weep for thee with bitterness of soul, with most bitter weeping. And they shall take up a mournful song for thee, and shall lament thee. What city is like Tyre, which is become silent in the midst of the sea? Which by thy merchandise that went from thee by sea didst fill many people, which by the multitude of thy riches, and of thy people didst enrich the kings of the earth. Now thou art destroyed by the sea, thy riches are in the bottom of the waters, and all the multitude that was in the midst of thee is fallen. All the inhabitants of the islands are astonished at thee, and all their kings being struck with the storm have changed their countenance. The merchants of people have hissed at thee, thou art brought to nothing, and thou shalt never be any more. The king of Tyre, who affected to be like to God, shall fall under the like sentence with Lucifer. The judgment of Sidon. The restoration of Israel. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, say to the prince of Tyre, Thus saith the Lord God, because thy heart is lifted up, and thou hast said, I am God, and I sit in the chair of God in the heart of the sea, whereas thou art a man, and not God, and hast set thy heart as if it were the heart of God. Behold, thou art wiser than Daniel, no secret is hid from thee. In thy wisdom and thy understanding thou hast made thyself strong, and hast gotten gold and silver into thy treasures. By the greatness of thy wisdom, and by thy traffic thou hast increased thy strength, and thy heart is lifted up with thy strength. Thou art wiser than Daniel, viz., in thy own conceit. The wisdom of Daniel was so much celebrated in his days, that it became a proverb amongst the Chaldeans, when anyone would express an extraordinary wisdom, to say he was as wise as Daniel. Therefore, thus saith the Lord God, because thy heart is lifted up as the heart of God, therefore behold, I will bring upon thee strangers the strongest of the nations, and they shall draw their swords against the beauty of thy wisdom, and they shall defile thy beauty. They shall kill thee, and bring thee down, and thou shalt die the death of them that are slain in the heart of the sea. Wilt thou yet say before them that slay thee, I am God, whereas thou art a man, and not God, in the hand of them that slay thee? Thou shalt die the death of the uncircumcised by the hand of strangers, for I have spoken it, saith the Lord God. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, take up a lamentation upon the king of Tyre, and say to him, Thus saith the Lord God, Thou wast the seal of resemblance, full of wisdom, and perfect in beauty. Thou wast in the pleasures of the paradise of God, every precious stone was thy covering, the sardius, the topaz, and the jasper, the chrysolite, and the onyx, and the beryl, the sapphire, and the carbuncle, and the emerald, gold the work of thy beauty, and thy pipes were prepared in the day that thou wast created. Thou a cherub stretched out, and protecting, and I set thee in the holy mountain of God, thou hast walked in the midst of the stones of fire. Thou wast perfect in thy ways from the day of thy creation, until iniquity was found in thee. Thou wast the seal of resemblance, the king of Tyre, by his dignity and his natural perfections, bore in himself a certain resemblance to God, by reason of which he might be called the seal of resemblance, etc. But what is here said to him is commonly understood of Lucifer, the king over all the children of pride. A cherub stretched out, that is, thy wings extended. This alludes to the figure of the cherubims in the sanctuary, which with stretched out wings covered the ark. Ibid. The stones of fire, that is, bright and precious stones which sparkle like fire. By the multitude of thy merchandise, thy inner parts were filled with iniquity, and thou hast sinned, and I cast thee out from the mountain of God, and destroyed thee, O covering cherub, out of the midst of the stones of fire. And thy heart was lifted up with thy beauty, thou hast lost thy wisdom and thy beauty, I have cast thee to the ground, I have set thee before the face of kings, that they might behold thee. Thou hast defiled thy sanctuaries by the multitude of thy iniquities, and by the iniquity of thy traffic, therefore I will bring forth a fire from the midst of thee, to devour thee, and I will make thee as ashes upon the earth in the sight of all that see thee. All that shall see thee among the nations, shall be astonished at thee, thou art brought to nothing, and thou shalt never be any more. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, set thy face against Sidon, and thou shalt prophesy of it, and shalt say, Thus saith the Lord God, Behold I come against thee, Sidon, and I will be glorified in the midst of thee, and they shall know that I am the Lord, when I shall execute judgments in her, and shall be sanctified in her. And I will send into her pestilence, and blood in her streets, and they shall fall being slain by the sword on all sides in the midst thereof, and they shall know that I am the Lord. And the house of Israel shall have no more a stumbling block of bitterness, nor a thorn causing pain on every side round about them, of them that are against them, and they shall know that I am the Lord God. Thus saith the Lord God, When I shall have gathered together the house of Israel out of the people among whom they are scattered, I will be sanctified in them before the Gentiles, and they shall dwell in their own land, which I gave to my servant Jacob. And they shall dwell therein secure, and they shall build houses, and shall plant vineyards, and shall dwell with confidence, when I shall have executed judgments upon all that are their enemies round about, and they shall know that I am the Lord their God. The king of Egypt shall be overthrown, and his kingdom wasted, it shall be given to Nebuchadnezzar for his service against Tyre. In the tenth year, the tenth month, the 11th day of the month, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, set thy face against Pharaoh king of Egypt, and thou shalt prophesy of him, and of all Egypt, speak, and say, Thus saith the Lord God, Behold, I come against thee, Pharaoh king of Egypt, thou great dragon that liest in the midst of thy rivers, and sayest, The river is mine, and I made myself. But I will put a bridle in thy jaws, and I will cause the fish of thy rivers to stick to thy scales, and I will draw thee out of the midst of thy rivers, and all thy fish shall stick to thy scales. And I will cast thee forth into the desert, and all the fish of thy river, thou shalt fall upon the face of the earth, thou shalt not be taken up, nor gathered together, I have given thee for meat to the beasts of the earth, and to the fowls of the air, and I will call in the sword against him in all my mountains, saith the Lord God, every man's sword shall be pointed against his brother. And I will judge him with pestilence, and with blood, and with violent rain, and vast hailstones, I will rain fire and brimstone upon him, and upon his army, and upon the many nations that are with him. And I will be magnified, and I will be sanctified, And I will be known in the eyes of many nations, and they shall know that I am the Lord. God's judgments upon Gog. God's people were punished for their sins, but shall be favored with everlasting kindness. And thou, son of man, prophesy against Gog, and say, Thus saith the Lord God, Behold, I come against thee, O Gog, the chief prince of Mozok and Thubal. And I will turn thee round, and I will lead thee out, and will make thee go up from the northern parts, and will bring thee upon the mountains of Israel. And I will break thy bow in thy left hand, and I will cause thy arrows to fall out of thy right hand. Thou shalt fall upon the mountains of Israel, thou and all thy bands, and thy nations that are with thee. I have given thee to the wild beasts, to the birds, and to every fowl, and to the beasts of the earth to be devoured. Thou shalt fall upon the face of the field, for I have spoken it, saith the Lord God. And I will send a fire on Magog, and on them that dwell confidently in the islands, and they shall know that I am the Lord. And I will make my holy name known in the midst of my people Israel, and my holy name shall be profaned no more, and the Gentiles shall know that I am the Lord, the Holy One of Israel. Behold, it cometh, and it is done, saith the Lord God, this is the day whereof I have spoken. And the inhabitants shall go forth of the cities of Israel, and shall set on fire and burn the weapons, the shields, and the spears, the bows and the arrows, and the hand staves and the pikes, and they shall burn them with fire 7 years. And they shall not bring wood out of the countries, nor cut down out of the forests, for they shall burn the weapons with fire, and shall make a prey of them to whom they had been a prey, and they shall rob those that robbed them, saith the Lord God. And it shall come to pass in that day, that I will give Gog a noted place for a sepulchre in Israel, the valley of the passengers on the east of the sea, which shall cause astonishment in them that pass by, and there shall they bury Gog, and all his multitude, and it shall be called the valley of the multitude of Gog. And the house of Israel shall bury them for 7 months to cleanse the land. And all the people of the land shall bury him, and it shall be unto them a noted day, wherein I was glorified, saith the Lord God. And they shall appoint men to go continually about the land, to bury and to seek out them that were remaining upon the face of the earth, that they may cleanse it, and after 7 months they shall begin to seek. And they shall go about passing through the land, and when they shall see the bone of a man, they shall set up a sign by it, till the buriers bury it in the valley of the multitude of Gog. And the name of the city shall be Amona, and they shall cleanse the land. And thou, O son of man, saith the Lord God, say to every fowl, and to all the birds, and to all the beasts of the field, assemble yourselves, make haste, come together from every side to my victim, which I slay for you, a great victim upon the mountains of Israel, to eat flesh, and drink blood. You shall eat the flesh of the mighty, and you shall drink the blood of the princes of the earth, of rams, and of lambs, and of he-goats, and bullocks, and of all that are well fed and fat. And you shall eat the fat till you be full, and shall drink blood till you be drunk of the victim which I shall slay for you. And you shall be filled at my table with horses, and mighty horsemen, and all the men of war, saith the Lord God. And I will set my glory among the nations, and all nations shall see my judgment that I have executed, and my hand that I have laid upon them. And the house of Israel shall know that I am the Lord their God from that day and forward. And the nations shall know that the house of Israel were made captives for their iniquity, because they forsook me, and I hid my face from them, and I delivered them into the hands of their enemies, and they fell all by the sword. I have dealt with them according to their uncleanness and wickedness, and hid my face from them. Therefore, thus saith the Lord God, Now will I bring back the captivity of Jacob, and will have mercy on all the house of Israel, and I will be jealous for my holy name. And they shall bear their confusion, and all the transgressions wherewith they have transgressed against me, when they shall dwell in their land securely fearing no man, and I shall have brought them back from among the nations, and shall have gathered them together out of the lands of their enemies, and shall be sanctified in them, in the sight of many nations. And they shall know that I am the Lord their God, because I caused them to be carried away among the nations, and I have gathered them together unto their own land, and have not left any of them there. And I will hide my face no more from them, for I have poured out my spirit upon all the house of Israel, saith the Lord God. The prophet sees in a vision the rebuilding of the temple, the dimensions of several parts thereof. In the 25th year of our captivity, in the beginning of the year, the 10th day of the month, the 14th year after the city was destroyed, in the selfsame day the hand of the Lord was upon me, and he brought me thither. In the visions of God he brought me into the land of Israel, and set me upon a very high mountain, upon which there was as the building of a city, bending towards the south. And he brought me in thither, and behold a man, whose appearance was like the appearance of brass, with a line of flax in his hand, and a measuring reed in his hand, and he stood in the gate. And this man said to me, Son of man, see with thy eyes, and hear with thy ears, and set thy heart upon all that I shall show thee, for thou art brought hither that they may be shown to thee, declare all that thou sayest, to the house of Israel. And behold there was a wall on the outside of the house round about, and in the man's hand a measuring reed of 6 cubits and a hand breadth, and he measured the breadth of the building 1 reed, and the height 1 reed. And he came to the gate that looked toward the east, and he went up the steps thereof, and he measured the breadth of the threshold of the gate 1 reed, that is, one threshold was 1 reed broad, and every little chamber was 1 reed long, and 1 reed broad, and between the little chambers were 5 cubits, and the threshold of the gate by the porch of the gate within, was 1 reed. And he measured the porch of the gate 8 cubits, and the front thereof 2 cubits, and the porch of the gate was inward. And the little chambers of the gate that looked eastward were 3 on this side, and 3 on that side, all 3 were of 1 measure, and the fronts of 1 measure, on both parts. And he measured the breadth of the threshold of the gate 10 cubits, and the length of the gate 13 cubits, and the border before the little chambers 1 cubit, and 1 cubit was the border on both sides, and the little chambers were 6 cubits on this side and that side. And he measured the gate from the roof of one little chamber to the roof of another, in breadth 25 cubits, door against door. He made also fronts of 60 cubits, and to the front the court of the gate on every side round about. And before the face of the gate which reached even to the face of the porch of the inner gate, 50 cubits. And slanting windows in the little chambers, and in their fronts, which were within the gate on every side round about, and in like manner there were also in the porches windows round about within, and before the fronts the representation of palm trees. And he brought me into the outward court, and behold there were chambers, and a pavement of stone in the court round about, 30 chambers encompassed the pavement. And the pavement in the front of the gates according to the length of the gates was lower. And he measured the breadth from the face of the lower gate to the front of the inner court without, 100 cubits to the east, and to the north. He measured also both the length and the breadth of the gate of the outward court, which looked northward. There were chambers, gazephilesa, so called, because the priests and Levites kept in them the stores and vessels that belonged to the temple. And the little chambers thereof 3 on this side, and 3 on that side, and the front thereof, and the porch thereof according to the measure of the former gate, 50 cubits long, and 25 cubits broad. And the windows thereof, and the porch, and the gravings according to the measure of the gate that looked to the east, and they went up to it by 7 steps, and a porch was before it. And the gate of the inner court was over against the gate of the north, and that of the east, and he measured from gate to gate 100 cubits. And he brought me out to the way of the south, and behold the gate that looked to the south, and he measured the front thereof, and the porch thereof according to the former measures. And the windows thereof, and the porches round about, as the other windows, the length was 50 cubits, and the breadth 25 cubits. And there were 7 steps to go up to it, and a porch before the doors thereof, and there were graven palm trees, one on this side, and another on that side in the front thereof. And there was a gate of the inner court towards the south, and he measured from gate to gate towards the south, 100 cubits. And he brought me into the inner court at the south gate, and he measured the gate according to the former measures. The little chamber thereof, and the front thereof, and the porch thereof with the same measures, and the windows thereof, and the porch thereof round about it was 50 cubits in length, and 25 cubits in breadth, and the porch round about was 25 cubits long, and 5 cubits broad. And the porch thereof to the outward court, and the palm trees thereof in the front, and there were 8 steps to go up to it. And he brought me into the inner court by the way of the east, and he measured the gate according to the former measures. The little chamber thereof, and the front thereof, and the porch thereof as before, and the windows thereof, and the porches thereof round about it was 50 cubits long, and 25 cubits broad. And the porch thereof, that is, of the outward court, and the graven palm trees in the front thereof on this side and on that side, and the going up thereof was by 8 steps. And he brought me into the gate that looked to the north, and he measured according to the former measures. The little chamber thereof, and the front thereof, and the porch thereof, and the windows thereof round about it was 50 cubits long, and 25 cubits broad. And the porch thereof looked to the outward court, and the graving of palm trees in the front thereof was on this side and on that side, and the going up to it was by 8 steps. And at every chamber was a door in the forefronts of the gates, there they washed the holocaust. And in the porch of the gate were 2 tables on this side, and 2 tables on that side, that the holocaust, and the sin offering, and the trespass offering might be slain thereon. And on the outward side, which goeth up to the entry of the gate that looketh toward the north, were 2 tables, and at the other side before the porch of the gate were 2 tables. 4 tables were on this side, and 4 tables on that side, at the sides of the gate were 8 tables, upon which they slew the victims. And the 4 tables for the holocausts were made of square stones, 1 cubit and a half long, and 1 cubit and a half broad, and 1 cubit high, to lay the vessels upon, in which the holocaust and the victim is slain. And the borders of them were of 1 hand breadth, turned inwards round about, and upon the tables was the flesh of the offering. And without the inner gate were the chambers of the singing men in the inner court, which was on the side of the gate that looketh to the north, and their prospect was towards the south, 1 at the side of the east gate, which looketh toward the north. And he said to me, "This chamber, which looketh toward the south, shall be for the priests that watch in the wards of the temple. But the chamber that looketh towards the north shall be for the priests that watch over the ministry of the altar. These are the sons of Zadok, who among the sons of Levi, come near to the Lord, to minister to him." And he measured the court 100 cubits long, and 100 cubits broad 4 square, and the altar that was before the face of the temple. And he brought me into the porch of the temple, and he measured the porch 5 cubits on this side, and 5 cubits on that side, and the breadth of the gate 3 cubits on this side, and 3 cubits on that side. And the length of the porch was 20 cubits, and the breadth 11 cubits, and there were 8 steps to go up to it. And there were pillars in the fronts, 1 on this side, and another on that side. A description of the temple, and of all the parts of it. And he brought me into the temple, and he measured the front 6 cubits broad on this side, and 6 cubits on that side, the breadth of the tabernacle. And the breadth of the gate was 10 cubits, and the sides of the gate 5 cubits on this side, and 5 cubits on that side, and he measured the length thereof 40 cubits, and the breadth 20 cubits. Then going inward he measured the front of the gate 2 cubits, and the gate 6 cubits, and the breadth of the gate 7 cubits. And he measured the length thereof 20 cubits, and the breadth 20 cubits, before the face of the temple, and he said to me, "This is the Holy of Holies." And he measured the wall of the house 6 cubits, and the breadth of every side chamber 4 cubits round about the house on every side. The temple, this plan of a temple, which was here shown to the prophet in a vision, partly had relation to the material temple, which was to be rebuilt, and partly, in a mystical sense, to the spiritual temple of God, the Church of Christ. And the side chambers one by another, were twice 33, and they bore outwards, that they might enter in through the wall of the house in the sides round about, to hold in, and not to touch the wall of the temple. And there was a broad passage round about, going up by winding stairs, and it led into the upper loft of the temple all round. Therefore was the temple broader in the higher parts, and so from the lower parts they went to the higher by the midst. And I saw in the house the height round about, the foundations of the side chambers which were the measure of a reed the space of 6 cubits, and the thickness of the wall for the side chamber without, which was 5 cubits, and the inner house was within the side chambers of the house. and between the chambers was the breadth of 20 cubits round about the house on every side. One by another, or one over another, literally, side to side, or side upon side. And the inner house was within the side chambers of the house, because these side chambers were in the very walls of the temple all round. Or, it may also be rendered, more agreeably to the Hebrew, so as to signify that the thickness of the wall for the side chamber within, was the same as that of the wall without, that is, equally 5 cubits. And the door of the side chambers was turned towards the place of prayer, one door was toward the north, and another door was toward the south, and the breadth of the place for prayer, was 5 cubits round about. And the building that was separate, and turned to the way that looked toward the sea, was 70 cubits broad, and the wall of the building, 5 cubits thick round about, and 90 cubits long. And he measured the length of the house, 100 cubits, and the separate building, and the walls thereof, 100 cubits in length. And the breadth before the face of the house, and of the separate place toward the east, 100 cubits. And he measured the length of the building over against it, which was separated at the back of it, and the galleries on both sides 100 cubits, and the inner temple, and the porches of the court. The thresholds, and the oblique windows, and the galleries round about on three sides, over against the threshold of every one, and floored with wood all round about, and the ground was up to the windows, and the windows were shut over the doors. And even to the inner house, and without all the wall round about within and without, by measure. And there were cherubims and palm trees wrought, so that a palm tree was between a cherub and a cherub, and every cherub had two faces. The face of a man was toward the palm tree on one side, and the face of a lion was toward the palm tree on the other side, set forth through all the house round about. From the ground even to the upper parts of the gate, were cherubims and palm trees wrought in the wall of the temple. The threshold was 4 square, and the face of the sanctuary, side to side. The altar of wood was 3 cubits high, and the length thereof was 2 cubits, and the corners thereof, and the length thereof, and the walls thereof were of wood. And he said to me, "This is the table before the Lord." And there were 2 doors in the temple, and in the sanctuary. And in the 2 doors on both sides were 2 little doors, which were folded within each other, for there were 2 wickets on both sides of the doors. And there were cherubims also wrought in the doors of the temple, and the figures of palm trees, like as were made on the walls, for which cause also the planks were thicker in the front of the porch without. The threshold was 4 square, that is, the gate of the temple was 4 square, and so placed as to answer the gate of the sanctuary within. Upon which were the oblique windows, and the representation of palm trees on this side, and on that side in the sides of the porch, according to the size of the house, and the breadth of the walls. A description of the courts, chambers, and other places belonging to the temple. And he brought me forth into the outward court by the way that leadeth to the north, and he brought me into the chamber that was over against the separate building, and over against the house toward the north. In the face of the north door was the length of 100 cubits, and the breadth of 50 cubits. Over against the 20 cubits of the inner court, and over against the pavement of the outward court that was paved with stone, where there was a gallery joined to a triple gallery. And before the chambers was a walk 10 cubits broad, looking to the inner parts of a way of 1 cubit. And their doors were toward the north. Where were the store chambers lower above, because they bore up the galleries, which appeared above out of them from the lower parts, and from the midst of the building. For they were of 3 stories, and had not pillars, as the pillars of the courts, therefore did they appear above out of the lower places, and out of the middle places, 50 cubits from the ground. And the outward wall that went about by the chambers, which were towards the outward court on the forepart of the chambers, was 50 cubits long. For the length of the chambers of the outward court was 50 cubits, and the length before the face of the temple, 100 cubits. And there was under these chambers, an entrance from the east, for them that went into them out of the outward court. In the breadth of the outward wall of the court that was toward the east, over against the separate building, and there were chambers before the building. And the way before them was like the chambers which were toward the north, they were as long as they, and as broad as they, and all the going into them, and their fashions, and their doors were alike. According to the doors of the chambers that were towards the south, there was a door in the head of the way, which way was before the porch, separated towards the east as one entereth in. And he said to me, "The chambers of the north, and the chambers of the south, which are before the separate building, they are holy chambers, in which the priests shall eat, that approach to the Lord into the Holy of Holies. There they shall lay the most holy things, and the offering for sin, and for trespass, for it is a holy place. And when the priests shall have entered in, they shall not go out of the holy places into the outward court, but there they shall lay their vestments, wherein they minister, for they are holy, and they shall put on other garments, and so they shall go forth to the people." Now when he had made an end of measuring the inner house, he brought me out by the way of the gate that looked toward the east, and he measured it on every side round about. And he measured toward the east with the measuring reed, 500 reeds with the measuring reed round about. And he measured toward the north 500 reeds with the measuring reed round about. And towards the south he measured 500 reeds with the measuring reed round about. And toward the west he measured 500 reeds, with the measuring reed. By the four winds he measured the wall thereof on every side round about, 500 cubits long and 500 cubits broad, making a separation between the sanctuary and the place of the people. The glory of God returns to the new temple. The Israelites shall no more profane God's name by idolatry. The prophet is commanded to show them the dimensions and form of the temple and of the altar, with the sacrifices to be offered thereon. And he brought me to the gate that looked towards the east. And behold, the glory of the God of Israel came in by the way of the east, and his voice was like the noise of many waters, and the earth shone with his majesty. And I saw the vision according to the appearance which I had seen when he came to destroy the city, and the appearance was according to the vision which I had seen by the river Chobar, and I fell upon my face. And the majesty of the Lord went into the temple by the way of the gate that looked to the east. And the Spirit lifted me up and brought me into the inner court, and behold, the house was filled with the glory of the Lord. And I heard one speaking to me out of the house, and the man that stood by me, said to me, "Son of man, the place of my throne, and the place of the soles of my feet, where I dwell in the midst of the children of Israel forever, and the house of Israel shall no more profane my holy name, they and their kings by their fornications, and by the carcasses of their kings, and by the high places. They who have set their threshold by my threshold, and their posts by my posts, and there was but a wall between me and them, and they profaned my holy name by the abominations which they committed, for which reason I consumed them in my wrath. Now therefore let them put away their fornications, and the carcasses of their kings far from me, and I will dwell in the midst of them forever. But thou, son of man, show to the house of Israel the temple, and let them be ashamed of their iniquities, and let them measure the building, and be ashamed of all that they have done. Show them the form of the house, and of the fashion thereof, the goings out and the comings in, and the whole plan thereof, and all its ordinances, and all its order, and all its laws, and thou shalt write it in their sight, that they may keep the whole form thereof, and its ordinances, and do them. This is the law of the house upon the top of the mountain. All its border round about is most holy. This then is the law of the house. And these are the measures of the altar by the truest cubit, which is a cubit and a hand breadth. The bottom thereof was a cubit, and the breadth a cubit, and the border thereof unto its edge, and round about, one hand breadth. And this was the trench of the altar. And from the bottom of the ground to the lowest brim 2 cubits, and the breadth of 1 cubit, and from the lesser brim to the greater brim 4 cubits, and the breadth of 1 cubit. And the aerial itself was 4 cubits, and from the aerial upwards were 4 horns. The aerial, that is, the altar itself, or rather the highest part of it, upon which the burnt offerings were laid. In the Hebrew it is Herul, that is, the mountain of God, but in the following verse Heriel, that is, the Lion of God, a figure, from its consuming, and as it were devouring the sacrifices, as a lion devours its prey. And the arrow was 12 cubits long, and 12 cubits broad, 4 square, with equal sides. And the brim was 14 cubits long, and 14 cubits broad in the 4 corners thereof, and the crown round about it was 1/2 cubit, and the bottom of it 1 cubit round about, and its steps turned toward the east. And he said to me, Son of man, thus saith the Lord God, these are the ceremonies of the altar, in what day soever it shall be made, that holocausts may be offered upon it, and blood poured out. And thou shalt give to the priests, and the Levites, that are of the race of Sadok, to approach to me, saith the Lord God, to offer to me a calf of the herd for sin. And thou shalt take of his blood, and shalt put it upon the four horns thereof, and upon the four corners of the brim, and upon the crown round about, and thou shalt cleanse, and expiate it. And thou shalt take the calf, that is offered for sin, and thou shalt burn him in a separate place of the house without the sanctuary. And in the second day thou shalt offer a he goat without blemish for sin, and they shall expiate the altar, as they expiated it with the calf. And when thou shalt have made an end of the expiation thereof, thou shalt offer a calf of the herd without blemish, and a ram of the flock without blemish. And thou shalt offer them in the sight of the Lord, and the priests shall put salt upon them, and shall offer them a holocaust to the Lord. 7 days shalt thou offer a he goat for sin daily, they shall offer also a calf of the herd, and a ram of the flock without blemish. 7 days shall they expiate the altar, and shall cleanse it, and they shall consecrate it. And the days being expired, on the 8th day and thenceforward, the priests shall offer your holocausts upon the altar, and the peace offerings, and I will be pacified towards you, saith the Lord God. Consecrate it, literally, fill its hand, that is, dedicate and apply it to holy service. The east gate of the sanctuary shall be always shut. The uncircumcised shall not enter into the sanctuary, nor the Levites that have served idols, but the sons of Sadok shall do the priestly functions, who stood firm in the worst of times. And he brought me back to the way of the gate of the outward sanctuary, which looked towards the east, and it was shut. And the Lord said to me, This gate shall be shut, it shall not be opened, and no man shall pass through it, because the Lord the God of Israel hath entered in by it, and it shall be shut for the prince. The prince himself shall sit in it, to eat bread before the Lord, he shall enter in by the way of the porch of the gate, and shall go out by the same way. And he brought me by the way of the north gate, in the sight of the house, and I saw, and behold the glory of the Lord filled the house of the Lord, and I fell on my face. And the Lord said to me, Son of man, attend with thy heart, and behold with thy eyes, and hear with thy ears, all that I say to thee concerning all the ceremonies of the house of the Lord, and concerning all the laws thereof, and mark well the ways of the temple, with all the goings out of the sanctuary. And thou shalt say to the house of Israel that provoketh me, Thus saith the Lord God, Let all your wicked doings suffice you, O house of Israel, in that you have brought in strangers uncircumcised in heart, and uncircumcised in flesh, to be in my sanctuary, and to defile my house, and you offer my bread, the fat, and the blood, and you have broken my covenant by all your wicked doings. And you have not kept the ordinances of my sanctuary, but you have set keepers of my charge in my sanctuary for yourselves. Thus saith the Lord God, No stranger uncircumcised in heart, and uncircumcised in flesh, shall enter into my sanctuary, no stranger that is in the midst of the children of Israel. Moreover the Levites that went away far from me, when the children of Israel went astray, and have wandered from me after their idols, and have borne their iniquity. They shall be officers in my sanctuary, and doorkeepers of the gates of the house, and ministers to the house, they shall slay the holocausts, and the victims of the people, and they shall stand in their sight, to minister to them. Because they ministered to them before their idols, and were a stumbling block of iniquity to the house of Israel, therefore have I lifted up my hand against them, saith the Lord God, and they shall bear their iniquity, and they shall not come near to me to do the office of priest to me, neither shall they come near to any of my holy things that are by the Holy of Holies, but they shall bear their shame, and their wickednesses which they have committed. And I will make them doorkeepers of the house, for all the service thereof, and for all that shall be done therein. But the priests, and Levites, the sons of Sadok, who kept the ceremonies of my sanctuary, when the children of Israel went astray from me, they shall come near to me, to minister to me, and they shall stand before me, to offer me the fat, and the blood, saith the Lord God. They shall enter into my sanctuary, and they shall come near to my table, to minister unto me, and to keep my ceremonies. And when they shall enter in at the gates of the inner court, they shall be clothed with linen garments, neither shall any woolen come upon them, when they minister in the gates of the inner court and within. They shall have linen mitres on their heads, and linen breeches on their loins, and they shall not be girded with anything that causeth sweat. And when they shall go forth to the outward court to the people, they shall put off their garments wherein they ministered, and lay them up in the store chamber of the sanctuary, and they shall clothe themselves with other garments, and they shall not sanctify the people with their vestments. Neither shall they shave their heads, nor wear long hair, but they shall only pull their heads. Shall not sanctify the people with their vestments, by exposing them to the danger of touching the sacred vestments, which none were to touch but they that were sanctified. And no priest shall drink wine when he is to go into the inner court. Neither shall they take to wife a widow, nor one that is divorced, but they shall take virgins of the seed of the house of Israel, but they may take a widow also, that is, the widow of a priest. And they shall teach my people the difference between holy and profane, and show them how to discern between clean and unclean. And when there shall be a controversy, they shall stand in my judgments, and shall judge, they shall keep my laws, and my ordinances in all my solemnities, and sanctify my Sabbaths. And they shall come near no dead person, lest they be defiled, only their father and mother, and son and daughter, and brother and sister, that hath not had another husband, for whom they may become unclean. And after one is cleansed, they shall reckon unto him 7 days. And in the day that he goeth into the sanctuary, to the inner court, to minister unto me in the sanctuary, he shall offer for his sin, saith the Lord God. And they shall have no inheritance, I am their inheritance, neither shall you give them any possession in Israel, for I am their possession. They shall eat the victim both for sin and for trespass, and every vowed thing in Israel shall be theirs. And the firstfruits of all the firstborn, and all the libations of all things that are offered, shall be the priestess. And you shall give the firstfruits of your meats to the priest, that he may return a blessing upon thy house. The priest shall not eat of anything that is dead of itself or caught by a beast, whether it be fowl or cattle. Portions of land for the sanctuary, for the city, and for the prince. Ordinances for the prince. And when you shall begin to divide the land by lot, separate ye firstfruits to the Lord, a portion of the land to be holy, in length 25,000 and in breadth 10,000, it shall be holy in all the borders thereof round about. And there shall be for the sanctuary on every side 500 by 500, 4 square round about, and 50 cubits for the suburbs thereof round about. And with this measure thou shalt measure the length of 25,000, and the breadth of 10,000, and in it shall be the temple and the holy of holies. The holy portion of the land shall be for the priests, the ministers of the sanctuary, who come near to the ministry of the Lord, and it shall be a place for their houses, and for the holy place of the sanctuary. And 25,000 of length, and 10,000 of breadth shall be for the Levites, that minister in the house, they shall possess 20 store chambers. 25,000, viz., reeds or cubits. And you shall appoint the possession of the city 5,000 broad, and 25,000 long, according to the separation of the sanctuary, for the whole house of Israel. For the prince also on the one side and on the other side, according to the separation of the sanctuary, and according to the possession of the city, over against the separation of the sanctuary, and over against the possession of the city, from the side of the sea even to the sea, and from the side of the east even to the east. And the length according to every part from the west border to the east border. He shall have a portion of the land in Israel, and the princes shall no more rob my people, but they shall give the land to the house of Israel according to their tribes. Thus saith the Lord God, let it suffice you, O princes of Israel, cease from iniquity and robberies, and execute judgment and justice, separate your confines from my people, saith the Lord God. You shall have just balances, and a just ephah, and a just bait. The ephah and the bait shall be equal, and of one measure, that the bait may contain the tenth part of a cor, and the ephah the tenth part of a cor, their weight shall be equal according to the measure of a cor. And the sickle hath 20 obols. Now 20 sickles, and 25 sickles, and 15 sickles make a. And these are the first fruits, which you shall take, the sixth part of an ephah of a korah of wheat, and the sixth part of an ephah of a korah of barley. The measure of oil also, a bait of oil is the tenth part of a korah, and 10 baits make a korah, for 10 baits fill a korah. And 1 ram out of a flock of 200, of those that Israel feedeth for sacrifice, and for holocausts, and for peace offerings, to make atonement for them, saith the Lord God. The ephah and the bait, these measures were of equal capacity, but the bait served for liquids, and the ephah for dry things. All the people of the land shall be bound to these first fruits for the prince in Israel. And the prince shall give the holocaust, and the sacrifice, and the libations on the feasts, and on the new moons, and on the Sabbaths, and on all the solemnities of the house of Israel, he shall offer the sacrifice for sin, and the holocaust, and the peace offerings to make expiation for the house of Israel. Thus saith the Lord God, in the first month, the first of the month, thou shalt take a calf of the herd without blemish, and thou shalt expiate the sanctuary. And the priest shall take of the blood of the sin offering, and he shall put it on the posts of the house, and on the four corners of the brim of the altar, and on the posts of the gate of the inner court. And so shalt thou do in the seventh day of the month, for every one that hath been ignorant, and hath been deceived by error, and thou shalt make expiation for the house. In the first month, the 14th day of the month, you shall observe the solemnity of the Pasch, 7 days unleavened bread shall be eaten. And the prince on the day shall offer for himself, and for all the people of the land, a calf for sin. And in the solemnity of the 7 days he shall offer for a holocaust to the Lord, 7 calves, and 7 rams without blemish daily for 7 days, and for sin a he goat daily. And he shall offer the sacrifice of an ephah for every calf, and an ephah for every ram, and a hin of oil for every ephah. In the 7th month, in the 15th day of the month, in the solemn feast, he shall do the like for the 7 days, as well in regard to the sin offering, as to the holocaust, and the sacrifice, and the oil. Other ordinances for the prince and for the sacrifices. Thus saith the Lord God, the gate of the inner court that looketh toward the east, shall be shut the 6 days, on which work is done, but on the Sabbath day it shall be opened, yea, and on the day of the new moon it shall be opened. And the prince shall enter by the way of the porch of the gate from without, and he shall stand at the threshold of the gate, and the priests shall offer his holocaust, and his peace offerings, and he shall adore upon the threshold of the gate, and shall go out, but the gate shall not be shut till the evening. And the people of the land shall adore at the door of that gate before the Lord on the Sabbaths, and on the new moons. And the holocaust that the prince shall offer to the Lord on the Sabbath day, shall be 6 lambs without blemish, and a ram without blemish. And the sacrifice of an ephah for a ram, but for the lambs what sacrifice his hand shall allow, and a hin of oil for every ephah. And on the day of the new moon a calf of the herd without blemish, and the 6 lambs, and the rams shall be without blemish. And he shall offer in sacrifice an ephah for a calf, an ephah also for a ram, but for the lambs, as his hand shall find, and a hin of oil for every ephah. And when the prince is to go in, let him go in by the way of the porch of the gate, and let him go out the same way. But when the people of the land shall go in before the Lord in the solemn feasts, he that goeth in by the north gate to adore, shall go out by the way of the south gate, and he that goeth in by the way of the south gate, shall go out by the way of the north gate, he shall not return by the way of the gate whereby he came in, but shall go out at that over against it. And the prince in the midst of them, shall go in when they go in, and go out when they go out. And in the fairs, and in the solemnities there shall be the sacrifice of an ephah to a calf, and an ephah to a ram, and to the lambs, the sacrifice shall be as his hand shall find, and a hin of oil to every ephah. But when the prince shall offer a voluntary holocaust, or voluntary peace offerings to the Lord, the gate that looketh towards the east shall be opened to him, and he shall offer his holocaust, and his peace offerings, as it is wont to be done on the Sabbath day, and he shall go out, and the gate shall be shut after he is gone forth. And he shall offer every day for a holocaust to the Lord, a lamb of the same year without blemish, he shall offer it always in the morning. And he shall offer the sacrifice for it morning by morning, the 6th part of an ephah, and the third part of a hin of oil be mingled with the fine flour, a sacrifice to the Lord by ordinance continual and everlasting. He shall offer the lamb, and the sacrifice, and the oil morning by morning, an everlasting holocaust. Thus saith the Lord God, if the prince give a gift to any of his sons, the inheritance of it shall go to his children, they shall possess it by inheritance. But if he give a legacy out of his inheritance to one of his servants, it shall be his until the year of release, and it shall return to the prince, but his inheritance shall go to his sons. And the prince shall not take of the people's inheritance by violence, nor of their possession, but out of his own possession he shall give an inheritance to his sons, that my people be not dispersed every man from his possession. And he brought me in by the entry that was at the side of the gate, into the chambers of the sanctuary that were for the priests, which looked toward the north. And there was a place bending to the west. And he said to me, this is the place where the priests shall boil the sin offering, and the trespass offering, where they shall dress the sacrifice, that they may not bring it out into the outward court, and the people be sanctified. And he brought me into the outward court, and he led me about by the four corners of the court, and behold there was a little court in the corner of the court, to every corner of the court there was a little court. In the four corners of the court were little courts disposed, 40 cubits long, and 30 broad, all the four were of one measure. And there was a wall round about compassing the four little courts, and there were kitchens built under the rows round about. And he said to me, this is the house of the kitchens wherein the ministers of the house of the Lord shall boil the victims of the people. The vision of the holy waters issuing out from under the temple, the borders of the land to be divided among the 12 tribes. And he brought me again to the gate of the house, and behold waters issued out from under the threshold of the house toward the east, for the forefront of the house looked toward the east, but the waters came down to the right side of the temple to the south part of the altar. And he led me out by the way of the north gate, and he caused me to turn to the way without the outward gate to the way that looked toward the east, and behold there ran out waters on the right side. And when the man that had the line in his hand went out towards the east, he measured 1,000 cubits, and he brought me through the water up to the ankles. And again he measured 1,000, and he brought me through the water up to the knees. And he measured 1,000, and he brought me through the water up to the loins. And he measured 1,000, and it was a torrent, which I could not pass over, for the waters were risen so as to make a deep torrent, which could not be passed over. Waters, these waters are not to be understood literally, for there were none such that flowed from the temple, but mystically, of the baptism of Christ, and of his doctrine and his grace. The trees that grow on the banks are Christian virtues, the fishes are Christians, that spiritually live in and by these holy waters. The fishermen are the apostles, and apostolic preachers. The fenny places, where there is no health, are such as by being out of the church are separated from these waters of life. And he said to me, surely thou hast seen, O son of man. And he brought me out, and he caused me to turn to the bank of the torrent. And when I had turned myself, behold on the bank of the torrent were very many trees on both sides. And he said to me, these waters that issue forth toward the hillocks of sand to the east, and go down to the plains of the desert, shall go into the sea, and shall go out, and the waters shall be healed. And every living creature that creepeth whithersoever the torrent shall come, shall live, and there shall be fishes in abundance. After these waters shall come thither, and they shall be healed, and all things shall live to which the torrent shall come. And the fishers shall stand over these waters. From Engedi even to Engalim there shall be drying of nets, there shall be many sorts of the fishes thereof, as the fishes of the great sea, a very great multitude. But on the shore thereof, and in the fenny places they shall not be healed, because they shall be turned into salt pits. And by the torrent on the banks thereof on both sides shall grow all trees that bear fruit, their leaf shall not fall off, and their fruit shall not fail, every month shall they bring forth first fruits. Because the waters thereof shall issue out of the sanctuary, and the fruits thereof shall be for food, and the leaves thereof for medicine. Thus saith the Lord God, this is the border, by which you shall possess the land according to the 12 tribes of Israel, for Joseph hath a double portion, and you shall possess it, every man in like manner as his brother, concerning which I lifted up my hands to give it to your fathers, and this land shall fall unto you for a possession. And this is the border of the land, toward the north side, from the great sea by the way of Hethilon, as men go to Sedada. Emath, Berotha, Sabarim, which is between the border of Damascus and the border of Amath, the house of Tikon, which is by the border of Aran. And the border from the sea even to the court of Anan, shall be the border of Damascus, and from the north to the north, the border of Amath, this is the north side. And the east side is from the midst of Aran, and from the midst of Damascus, and from the midst of Galad, and from the midst of the land of Israel, Jordan making the bound to the east sea, and thus you shall measure the east side. And the south side southward is from Thamar even to the waters of contradiction of Gades, and the torrent even to the great sea, and this is the south side southward. And the side toward the sea, is the great sea from the borders straight on, till thou come to Amath, this is the side of the sea. And you shall divide this land unto you by the tribes of Israel, and you shall divide it by lot for an inheritance to you, and to the strangers that shall come over to you, that shall beget children among you, and they shall be unto you as men of the same country born among the children of Israel, they shall divide the possession with you in the midst of the tribes of Israel. And in what tribe soever the stranger shall be, there shall you give him possession, saith the Lord God. The portions of the 12 tribes, of the sanctuary, of the city, and of the prince. The dimensions and gates of the city. And these are the names of the tribes from the borders of the north, by the way of Hethilon, as they go to Amath, the court of Anan, the border of Damascus northward, by the way of Amath. And from the east side thereof to the sea, shall be one portion for Dan. And by the border of Dan, from the east side even to the side of the sea, one portion for Aser, and by the border of Aser, from the east side even to the side of the sea, one portion for Naphtali. And by the border of Naphtali, from the east side even to the side of the sea, one portion for Manasses. And by the border of Manasses, from the east side even to the side of the sea, one portion for Ephraim. And by the border of Ephraim, from the east side even to the side of the sea, one portion for Reuben. And by the border of Reuben, from the east side even to the side of the sea, one portion for Judah. And by the border of Judah, from the east side even to the side of the sea, shall be the first fruits which you shall set apart, 25,000 in breadth, and in length, as every one of the portions from the east side to the side of the sea, and the sanctuary shall be in the midst thereof. The first fruits which you shall set apart for the Lord, shall be the length of 25,000, and the breadth of 10,000. And these shall be the first fruits of the sanctuary for the priests, toward the north 25,000 in length, and toward the sea 10,000 in breadth, and toward the east also 10,000 in breadth, and toward the south 25,000 in length, and the sanctuary of the Lord shall be in the midst thereof. The sanctuary shall be for the priests of the sons of Sadok, who kept my ceremonies, and went not astray when the children of Israel went astray, as the Levites also went astray. And for them shall be the first fruits of the first fruits of the land holy of holies, by the border of the Levites. And the Levites in like manner shall have by the borders of the priests 25,000 in length, and 10,000 in breadth. All the length shall be 25,000, and the breadth 10,000. And they shall not sell thereof, nor exchange, neither shall the first fruits of the land be alienated, because they are sanctified to the Lord. But the 5,000 that remain in the breadth over against the 25,000, shall be a profane place for the city for dwelling, and for suburbs, and the city shall be in the midst thereof. And these are the measures thereof, on the north side 4,500, and on the south side 4,500, and on the east side 4,500, and on the west side 4,500. And the suburbs of the city shall be to the north 250, and to the south 250, and to the east 250, and to the sea 250. And the residue in length by the first fruits of the sanctuary, 10,000 toward the east, and 10,000 toward the west, shall be as the first fruits of the sanctuary, and the fruits thereof shall be for bread to them that serve the city. And they that serve the city, shall serve it out of all the tribes of Israel. All the first fruits, of 25,000, by 25,000 foursquare, shall be set apart for the first fruits of the sanctuary, and for the possession of the city. And the residue shall be for the prince on every side of the first fruits of the sanctuary, and of the possession of the city over against the 25,000 of the first fruits unto the east border, toward the sea also over against the 25,000, unto the border of the sea, shall likewise be the portion of the prince, and the first fruits of the sanctuary, and the sanctuary of the temple shall be in the midst thereof. And from the possession of the Levites, and from the possession of the city which are in the midst of the prince's portions, what shall be to the border of Judah, and to the border of Benjamin, shall also belong to the prince. And for the rest of the tribes, from the east side to the west side, one portion for Benjamin. And over against the border of Benjamin, from the east side to the west side, one portion for Simeon. And by the border of Simeon, from the east side to the west side, one portion for Issachar. And by the border of Issachar, from the east side to the west side, one portion for Zabulon. And by the border of Zabulon, from the east side to the side of the sea, one portion for Gad. And by the border of Gad, the south side southward, and the border shall be from Tamar, even to the waters of contradiction of Gades, the inheritance over against the great sea. This is the land which you shall divide by lot to the tribes of Israel, and these are the portions of them, saith the Lord God. And these are the goings out of the city: on the north side thou shalt measure 4,500. And the gates of the city according to the names of the tribes of Israel: 3 gates on the north side, the gate of Reuben 1, the gate of Judah 1, the gate of Levi 1. And at the east side, 4,500, and 3 gates, the gate of Joseph 1, the gate of Benjamin 1, the gate of Dan 1. And at the south side, thou shalt measure 4,500, and 3 gates, the gate of Simeon 1, the gate of Issachar 1, the gate of Zabulon 1. And at the west side, 4,500, and there 3 gates, the gate of Gad 1, the gate of Aser 1, the gate of Naphtali 1. Its circumference was 18,000, and the name of the city from that day, The Lord is There. The Lord is There, this name is here given to the city, that is, to the Church of Christ, because the Lord is always with her till the end of the world. Matthew 28 verse 20.